Hey, Riggs here. I have been looking to make an avatar deformer, and I wasn't able to find anything that's not using Bento Body or Avatar or some other paid asset add-on for Blender. So I'm doing this tutorial, and now that I've figured it out, since it took me quite a while. So what you want to do is go to this wiki page. And scroll down, you're gonna find this methods thing, but as it says here, it's out of date. So this doesn't actually work anymore. As you can see here, they're telling you to edit BioVision files, but you can no longer upload BioVision files that move the bones, like the bone position. The only bone position that you're allowed to move anymore is the hip. Like the root bone of the avatar. So this doesn't work. But if you scroll further down to this second method, this actually does work. And I've been able to make an avatar deformation using this. So what you want to do is click here, and it'll take you to this page where you're gonna find some default models to use. So once you get that, you want to jump into Blender, delete the default cube, and then go import Collada. This is gonna allow you to import your file that you just downloaded. Here's the file I got from SL, right? And this is gonna be your avatar. Let's say, for example, you just want to make your avatar a wee bit taller, right? So what you're gonna want to do is get to whatever bones you need to stretch. In this case, I'm gonna use the spine one as an example. So hit Control Tab to go into pose mode. It's gonna automatically go into pose mode if you have selected the armature. So you wanna find the bone you wanna stretch. Now select it. I just hit G to move, and then Z to snap to the Z axis and move, right? So I'm gonna move it 2 meters up, right? And it's gonna end up looking like this. So once you are happy with all the modifications you've done, then you wanna select all the bones. And then hit Control A and then apply pose as rest pose. Once you've done that, you're gonna see the avatar returns to its normal position. And then you can go ahead and exit out of pose mode with Control Tab again. Now, what you wanna do is select avatar here, your avatar that you just modified. Actually, no, sorry. Next thing we wanna do is add another mesh to avoid uploading this complex mesh. So it's gonna, because if we upload this to Second Life, it's gonna cost us more. So what we're gonna do is hit Shift A to add a mesh and then mesh. And I'm gonna use a cube in this case. I'm gonna scale it with S and then move the mouse, bring it up, scale it a little bit more. That's okay. Doesn't really matter what the mesh looks like or what it is. It's just there for our purposes. So what you're gonna wanna do next is right-click the mesh and then click the avatar with Shift. Or you can alternatively do it like this from the viewer. Not with Shift, sorry, with Control. Because otherwise you're gonna select the camera too. Right? Like this. So click and then holding Control, click on your armature. Then you hit Control P, and we're gonna use armature deform here. You don't wanna use empty groups, envelope weights, or automatic weights because it's gonna create vertex groups that you don't necessarily want. So, armature deform, and you notice what's gonna do is it's gonna make our cube part of the armature. After that, you can just go ahead and delete this or leave it there. just make sure you delete it before uploading to Second Life, otherwise you're going to be uploading them, those meshes. And then you go here to vertex groups, right? And on the cube, you're going to want to add the vertex groups of the bones you've modified. And you're going to want to add all the vertex, all the bones that you have in the hierarchy. For example, I modified spine 1, so I need to add spine 1 and then pelvis, which is our root bone. If I, for example, modify, I don't know, the M hip, right, for example, if I modify this one too, I would need to add spine 1, M hip right, and then pelvis. Okay, so we're going to go back to our cube. You see we added two groups. Then we're going to hit F2 to be able to copy this. Just hit Control C to copy it, and then escape to exit out of it. Go back to the cube, double click on the name, and then Control V. There we go. We just have our vertex group with the same name after as the bone we modified. Let's do the same thing with our spine one. Double click, Control V, enter, and there we go. So what this does is it tells Blender which vertex groups within the object are assigned to which bones, but we haven't done that yet. We just created the vertex groups. Now we need to tell it which vertices each vertex group affects, right? Which vertices are part of which vertex groups. So to do that, now we're going to select our cube, Control Tab, and then weight paint. And this allows us to tell Blender how much each vertice is affected by the vertex group. For example, I'm just going to do it all, with my strength set to 1. I'm just going to paint the entire cube red, which means it's affected the most it can be affected. This doesn't really matter. We just need it to be affected by the bone through the vertex group, because if we don't set this, Second Life, it's going to think that the bone is not used and it's going to ignore it. So let's just do this with all of our vertex groups that we have created based on the bones that we have modified. And once that's done, you can exit out of weight paint and go back to object mode. And now we're ready to export it. To export it, I'm going to use an add-on that I made that makes exporting Collada files and also animations easier. You can find it in the video description. You don't need to use the add-on though. You can just hit export and then Collada and it'll work. I'm just going to use the add-on because it's easier. So we go File, Export. You're going to find these options, Snowflake, SL, Collada, right? And then we just find where we want to store it. In this case, I'm going to put it here, test.die, and then save, right? We have exported that file. Now we're going to come to Second Life. What we're going to do is hit Build, Upload, Mesh Model, and then we're just going to select our file, test.die, right? We hit open, and once it's loaded, you are going to want to make sure that you go to rigging and select the option include joint positions. That way it's going to include our modifications to the joint positions. Now we can give it a name. I'm just going to call it test deform, and then hit calculate. So it calculates how much it's going to cost us to upload. And then upload. And once that's done, you can just right click add and it'll deform your avatar. And I don't know why the cube is hidden right now. Okay, it's not, it's just inside of the avatar. Now what you want to do to get rid of this cube is just right click edit, either there or in the inventory, and then you go texture, transparency, and set it to 100. It means 100% transparency. Then you can just close out of that, and you have successfully made a deform. Thanks for watching.